I think he beat some Japanese player on stream. It might have been like 9B or something at the time. Sorry, QB.
I
believe this is about
sounds,
a year and a half
sounds familiar.
Ago.
I don't know about QB because Villager Bale.
No, but it was. I remember QB got knocked out very early in that tournament by somebody. But we're going on to our first game right here. JP already coming out with the triple turn up aggression, and now these grab combos coming out.
Fully space paper grab and trying to call the quick attack with the fair. JP already looking really comfortable. Let's see how Captain L starts to find his way in here. I will say Pikachu is one of those characters that can take a little bit of time to get comfortable in terms of figuring out, you know, how you want to get in. Is fairly short range, but with good movement options. So I would definitely expect to see a change in playstyle as the set goes on and Captain L starts to figure him out.
Well, it definitely helps in this matchup that he's a very short character, so he's going to be able to dodge a lot of those forward air aggressive pressure
yes.
that you see from a lot of Villager players. And Captain L's movement is something to be respected. This man is the king of perfect pivots and turnarounds that extend combos forever.
I know, Pikachu, since day one, has always been one of the hypest characters to watch. Like, since 64, this man has been a combo machine. Forever high-tier Pikachu, the meme is reality.
You know, Pikachu having to deal with this million bullets coming out of JP right now.
This bullet seed. Coming out, really putting Pikachu in check. You know, it doesn't have to be super effective, but got a little bit of chip in, and oh, all right, hitting the thunder, not quite enough to hold it out. Villager is a thick boy.
Yeah, this boy running away on his rocket. Now, way deep off stage, JP's gonna have to watch out. He's only got one balloon.
And this could be very dangerous, hot JP. Unfortunately, gonna slingshot the wrong way. Almost had a setup for an edgeguard scenario right there, which is.
Yeah, I respect going for the bowling ball right there. If Captain L actually instantly recovered with his upbeat, that would have been it for his stock. JP now trying to regain this stage control. He's sitting at full rage, has the tree going on in the center of the stage. And he has home court advantage, Kelso. How does this play into the matchup?
This is the mayor we're talking to right now. And that quick mash out, JP having none of that grab. Be looking for the edge. Pikachu
tilt.
Too short.
Up tilt not going to work in that scenario.
Pikachu is too short. But you know, JP is not one to be discouraged by a missed opportunity like that. That's just the Villager life, and you can see the persistence. This boy will not go down without a fight.
Oh, JP trying to mix it up under the stage with that upbeat Villager with one of the most ridiculous recoveries in the game. Only
fantastic
the single
coverage.
Turn up.
Yeah, the turnip is actually a really valuable. Ooh, almost catching that, but intelligent going over the ledge by Captain L. Not going to get caught in the basic bowling ball.
I think it's about time for JP to stop using these up tilts against Pikachu. We've already seen two whiff, just gives Pikachu so much time to get a punish on him.
Yeah, that can be one of those habits that's definitely difficult to break, since up tilt is a really reliable move for a Villager generally, especially against characters who are trying really hard to cross him up and move around. Unfortunately, Pikachu having, I would say it's a fair trade-off. You know.
Oh, wow, 4th of July out here. Taking Pikachu off the top. This is an even match right now, Kelso. This might upset some people at home.
I don't think anybody would be upset. You know, look at hardworking JP. You know, I don't think since customs have been turned off, anybody is out here hating on an honest, hardworking Villager.
That is true. Everybody loved Renai actually back in the day. Once customs were turned off.
Oh, he was a hero. He was a hero. The people's champ.
JP.
And, ooh, F throw. Interesting. I like the idea. Recognizing that he's out of a down throw confirm percent and just trying to get Pikachu off stage so he can keep looking for these edge guards. Villager definitely one of the better characters at edgeguarding Pikachu too, just because the active hitbox on his turnups make it really, really easy to cover Pikachu's movement options.
Now Captain L pouring on the pressure.
Man, the
re-grab
just keeps going. And JP with that landing nair. Doing a really good job. I like that JP is not getting over-eager about finding his way in. He's really, really focusing on just getting back to center stage and keeping himself there, since he knows that his bread and butter is going to be calling out Captain L's movements with his lingering hitboxes.
Yeah, JP with that Zen-like patience right now.
Almost
with the pressure off stage, trying to go for it all right there. But Pikachu, obviously one of the best recoveries in the game. Very hard to edge guard off the side of the stage right there.
And that Villager grab is going to get him thundered. I thought he would be able to make it back there.
Unfortunate, but JP does not seem too flustered after that game.
Oh, no. I mean, I think it was pretty clear. He was feeling comfortable.
Yeah.
He was feeling comfortable. That was, honestly, that was a really fun match to watch.
And JP's
a lot of back and forth. Not a lot of cheese coming out. You know, just some Honest callouts. Both these guys going for real callouts.
JP's brother from another mother right behind him. Bandit, the other villager main. These men are dressed very similar, Kelso.
Everyone knows all villager players are hipsters.
It's true. It's just I'm looking fact. At you in your shirt, too.
Almost finding it there. JP really just trying to make the most out of getting Captain L off stage. Ironic, given that Pikachu is one of the best recoveries in the game, but Villager really doesn't care.
Here we go. Captain L getting something started. Not a huge combo. It doesn't seem like in this matchup that Villager is of the weight class that Pikachu really excels at. He really excels at comboing those fast fallers and heavy characters. However, only just tacking on about 20% per combo in this matchup.
But yeah, Pikachu's early combo is definitely very vertical. Honestly, it's not even just Pikachu that struggles with it. Villager just seems to be at a weight where a lot of characters struggle to find opportunities on him. Even like higher percent kill confirms, he tends to have really small windows for things like Ding Dong.
Plus he has amazing combo breaking tools, right? Like that Nair.
Yeah, Villager is a character designed to basically just keep living.
That's true. How many times did we see Renai live upwards 180% just using those side beats to stay on the stage?
I mean, you know, it's Animal Crossing, man. This guy's just here to
jab block set up.
All right, that is gonna do it.
He's not gonna live that one, Kelso.
No, not today. Even Villager can't do it all, man. The mayor does not have infinite power. It's not a dictatorship, in Smashville.
It's not the oligarch villager that we've come to know.
He unfortunately does not have the absolute power he may desire. But, you know, he's trying to do the most he can with what's been given to him by the people. You know, respect democracy and you get a triple turnip. That is the power of the people, Andy.
This man is coming out like a tyrant now, Kelso. Uh-oh. Forward throw.
I support big government. Let's go. Right, JP trying to find his way up the ledge. It seems like Captain L has done a decent job of adapting in terms of he's not going for as many callouts as JP gets off the ledge. Instead, retreating to the center stage and recognizing the villager is going to have a really hard time getting back down once he commits to that jump.
Now Captain L has really caught on to JP's DI and his habits when he's getting thrown. So look to see Captain L looking out for another air dodge right there if he gets another up throw.
JP finds his way in the bowling ball, going to put on some good percent, and
if only that were the other way, that could have been close to a stock.
And you know, Pikachu, even though they're about the same size, Pikachu just doesn't have that density. You know, he's all fat, not as much muscle, so this is a much closer game than the percent may indicate, especially given the difficulty that Pikachu may have closing this out on Villager and getting that horizontal kill.
Here we go, JP trying to reestablish position on this stage. Sitting down more than 60% now.
Great stuff. I really appreciate JP's playstyle in terms of the fact that he knows how to play safe without playing scared.
That is true. And look at JP just with this perfect spacing rolling away.
The jab got the reverse hitbox, knocking Captain L off stage. That could have been a nasty scenario. Last hit of bear.
JP just stalling his recovery so long. Trying to make sure he gets back to the stage any way possible. This is what you were talking about, Kelso. This man is living forever.
A throw. All right, JP with the full hop nair. Not a whole lot Pikachu can do against that without a soft read.
This is actually quite the scary position for Pikachu right now, not being a very heavy character. And if he gets a triple turn up, especially that high on the stage.
I don't think, not quite yet, even with rage. Maybe 5 to 10 more percent.
I trust you. You are a resident villager main yourself, Kelso.
The back row knock by connecting, and I honestly think that was probably intentional by Captain L.
That is
really smart stuff. Getting the drift back, you know, how can you pass up that grab?
So unfortunate for JP.